What's up, guys? LOH of Low Tech. The Anycubic i3 Mega is a good 3D printer, but like most 3D printers, it can be a little more noisy than you're expecting. Noise from a 3D printer does come from two sources, fans and motors, but since the motors aren't constant, it's usually the most noticeable. Upgrading the drivers to TMC2208s should make a big difference. To get an understanding of how much noise the motors make, we first need to make a baseline for the printer when just the fans are running. A max of 67 decibels isn't quiet, but we'll leave that fan noise for a later upgrade. When printing a fairly easy print, in this case a desk hook, we see decibels peak at over 75. That's definitely loud and has passed irritating and is halfway towards unpleasant. Let's get this upgrade started. First thing we need to do is to disassemble the printer. Luckily, this is pretty straightforward. You just need to remove the bolts from the side, slide the base out from the extruder, and then remove the small bolts along the underside of the base. Next, we remove the two bolts that hold in the fan and bend the fan bracket back slightly, giving us access to the drivers. We can then remove the five drivers from the board, being careful to not bend the pins. We can then attach the heat sinks to the back of the TMC2208 drivers and install them in the same location as the original drivers. Be sure to install them in the correct orientation, which for me was having the blue driver pins facing the front of the case. Next, we need to reverse the cable orientation for the motors. Using needle nose pliers, you can pull out the five occupied white guide brackets. You can reinstall them backwards if you want, but I chose to leave them out. Then reconnect the wires with the connectors reversed. Take a picture for reference if you need something to look back onto. Finally, we'll want to calibrate the driver voltages. In reality, they should come tuned for 1.2 volts, which will work, but most recommend using something a bit lower. I decided to go with 0.85 volts as ideal. There are a few places you can touch to check the voltage, but I found that the bottom right hole and the top left ground connector to be the easiest for me to use. Make sure you use your voltmeter at DC and not AC. If the voltage is too high, you can loosen the bottom screw slightly, or if it's too low, you can tighten it a little bit. I use the included non-conductive screwdriver to be safe, but you can use whatever you want. And once all five drivers are set, we can reassemble the printer. With these new drivers printing the same part as before, the decibel reading is now peaking at 68, only one above the base fan noise and 7 times quieter than with the stock drivers. They definitely are not silent, but they are quiet enough now that I don't mind having the printer run all night in the other room. This is what all printers should be using from now on, and for $30, it's a great upgrade for the Anycubic i3 Mega. Thanks for watching, guys. This is LOH Low Tech, and you've been watching me install the TMC2208s into my Anycubic i3 Mega. Subscribe!